Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today I am going to cover the second part of the slope and deflection method, which is the analysis of indeterminate structures. And the structure that I am going to cover today is beam structures. I will going to cover the simply supported beams and overhanging beams, and then these beams with the support settlement in today's lecture. In the first part of the lectures, we have studied about the basics of slope and deflection methods, the various terminologies involved in it, and the derivation of the slope and deflection method. And the end of the lecture, we have also carried out a basic example of the application of slope and deflection method for beams. Today I am going to cover some further examples to make you understand in a better way that how this method is applied for the analysis of indeterminate structures. Well, in the last lecture I have told you that the basic slope and deflection equation that we have derived after the way performing the various mathematical steps, and we reach to this equation. That is, MNF is equal to 2EI over L into 2 times theta of N plus theta of F minus 3 times psi plus fixed end moment, where N is the indicate the near end of the beam, and F indicates the far end of the beam. And similarly, if we have a span of A to B, then it will become as MAP is equal to 2EI over L into 2 times theta at point A plus the deflection or the rotation at point B minus 3 times of psi plus fixed end moment in the span A to B. And we have also studied that there are some basics 12 steps in performing the analysis of the continuous beams. That first of all, we identify the degree of the freedom of the structure, that the number of the rotations available in the structure, and whether they are at the joints or they are at the supports. Then we compute the fixed end moments using the fixed end moment tables. Then if we have a settlement, then we find the value of the psi. If there is no settlement, then its value is taken as 0. Then we write the slope and deflection equation, which I have shown you in the last slide. And then we write equilibrium equation for each joint. And it depends on the number of the joints in the structure we have, or the number of the supports we have in the structures. And then we find out a number of unknown joint rotations, and later we calculate the member end moments by finding out by applying the slope and deflection equation. And then we check for the values, whether we are going in the right direction or not. And later on we compute the member end shears, then support reactions, SFDs and BMDs of the structures. And for fixed end of the moment, I have told you that we are going to use the fixed end moment tables, and these are the tables which are given in the inside back cover of the RC's papers book, and you can also refer these from the fixed end moment table. I have also uploaded these on the course webpage of the university. You can also access these moment tables from over there. And in these tables we have a number of combinations, where we have a point load at the center of the beam, then we have a point load which is away from the center of the beam, and its value of the moment is given here. What will the moment have, whether the moment is towards away from the beam or with the closer to the supports. Similarly, we have a number of lift loaded there. We have a 2 point load in the beam, then its fixed end moment formula is also given there. Similarly, if we have a 3 number of point loads in the beam, then its formula is also given as here. And if we have a prop cantilever beam and its moment is load is applied at the center, it has its own formula, while at the pin support there will be, or at the roller support, we do not consider any fixed end moment, because we modify the equation of slope and deflection in such a way that we only find out the moment at only on the fixed end. Later on, I'm going to solve a particular example using these mathematical equations or mathematical relations as well. And similarly, a slow termination when the moment is applied away from the center, when we have a number of increasing nodes or we have a multiple nodes and its value of the moment, you can easily find out from these values. Similarly, if we have a UDL load, then it's also moment values or fixed time moments are given in the RCF schedule. Whether we have a UDL on the entire span of the beam or we have a in the half of the span of the beam, you can find out its value quite easily. Similarly, if you have a varying distributed load or gradually increasing load or gradually decreasing loads, its moment values you can also find on the table as well. And at the end, we have some basic formula for the settlement of the beam as well. When there is a settlement in the beam, you can find out its moment, wedge stand moment as well. And similarly, prop cantilever moments are for each case are also given in these book covered as well. To move further ahead, let's directly jump into the example part to elaborate it further. For example, consider this example one, where we were supposed to find out the reactions and draw the SFDs and BMD diagrams for the continuous beam, which is shown in the figure here, where we have two spans A to B and B to C. And in the span A to B, it's the load is 18 kips and it is a point load at 10 feet from support A. And the total span length is 25 feet, which indicates that its point load is not acting at the center of the beam. Instead, it is closer to the point A because it is 10 feet from point A and from B it is 15 feet. And in the span B to C, we have a UDL distributed load over the entire span, a length of 30 feet. And the value of EI is given as the constant. As I told you, the very first step in the slope and deflection method is the calculation of the degree of the freedom. And for degree of the freedom, we look for the number of the unknown joint rotations in the structure. As we know that at the point A, we have a fixed support, at point B, we have a roller support, and at point C, we have again have a fixed support. At the fixed support, we do not have any rotation and do not have any deflection as well. There is no theta and no delta at the fixed support. But at the support B, which is the roller, we will have a rotation at that point as well. And that rotation is theta B, and which is indirectly is the only degree of the freedom in the structure. So in this structure, we have only one degree of freedom, and which is rotation at point B. The second step is the computation of the fixed end moment. And for fixed end movement, we will look into the fixed end table. As I told you that this point load acting in the span A to B is not at the center of the beam, but it is closer to the point A. And for that point, we will move towards the fixed end movement table. And from here, we will find out that it is the case 2, which is applicable in our case, where the fixed end movement when the load is closer to the support is its value is B A square B by L square, where A is the larger distance or the distance from maximum larger distance in the entire span, and B is the smaller distance or distance closer to the supports, and L is the entire span length. We will apply this formula B A square B by L square at the support B, when we are calculating movement at end B, and that is fixed end movement in the span AB, its formula will be B AB square by L square, and it will become as ultimately we have just plugged into the values into this formula, and it will become as 18 into 10 into 15, because B is the 15 square, which is the larger distance, and A is the smaller distance, over L square, which is the 25 feet. So its value will become as 64.8 kips feet. Similarly, for fixed end movement in the BA, considering the support B, its formula will be BA square B by L square. And its value will be taken as 18 into A is smaller distance, 10 square, B is largest distance, 15 feet over 25 feet square. And its value will become as 43.2 kips feet. Similarly, if we apply Fluke for the second span, it's in the second span we have an entire UDL over the entire beam. And the load condition that we click here is the first condition of the UDL load condition, and which indicates that fixed head moment is WL square by 12. So we will apply this formula WL square by 12 to find out the fixed head moment in the span BC, and it's very common up to be 150 kip thick. Similarly, in the span C to CB, the same formula will be used, and its value again will be the same, which is 150 kip thick. The direction indicates the whether the we will have a positive moment or the negative moment in the span. When we have anti-clockwise moment, it indicates that we will have positive fixed end moment. When direction is anti-clockwise, it means clockwise, it indicates that it is in the negative direction. We always, because it is the assumption that we used in the slope and deflection method, that counterclockwise or anti-clockwise moment are always considered as positive, whereas clockwise moments are always considered as the negative moments. Next step is the calculation of the cohort rotations. As there is no settlement, that we do neither the support A settles neither the B or the C, so this value will be zero. That is, both psi AB and psi BC will be zero. The step four is the writing of the slope and deflection equations, which I already mentioned you in the very second slide of today's lecture. But the interesting point that you need to remember is at the point A and at point C, we have a fixed support. Therefore, theta A and both theta C will be equal to zero. And the next step, we will apply the slope and deflection equations for member for both spans or for both member of the beam. For member AB, it will become as 2EI over L, where L is the total length of the span, which is 25 feet, into 2 times theta of A. As A is the fixed support, so its value will be 0. So only the left will be rotation as the theta B. And since there is no deflection, so its value of the psi will also be zero, plus fixed end moment, which is value calculated in the second step, and its value is 64.8. And once we simplify it, we will get the value of moment at AB is equal to 0.08 EI theta B plus 64.8, and it will become as the equation 1 of the problem. Similarly, moment in MBA will become as 2EI over theta into 2 times theta P, because we are looking at the point B. The first end will always be multiplied at near end. The near end of the beam is always multiplied with the 2. So it will become 2 times theta B plus theta A, which is value is 0, minus psi, and its psi is again 0. And we have the value of the plus fixed end moment, and fixed end moment here is minus 43.2. And the value is minus because it is in the clockwise direction. And once we simplify this equation, we will get the value of moment BA as 0.16 EI theta B minus 43.2. And it will become as the equation 2. Similarly, the for slope and deflection will be written for the member BC. And its value will become as the equation 3 and equation 4 by using the same above procedures. In the next step, we will draw the free body diagram to write the equilibrium equations of the structure. And we to write the equilibrium equation of the structure, what we do is that we split up the beam into number of spans, and spans depend on the number of the supports we have. And here we have one span is A to B, another span is B to C. So we will simplify the A to B and only show the loading condition and show the direction of the moments or fixed end moments. Then we will have support B at the point roller support, which is the roller support effect. And as this the span AB, if we have a reaction in the upward direction, then at the support its value will be in downward direction, or its shear will be in opposite direction. Similarly, if we have a clockwise moment in, or anti-clockwise moment in the span AB, then at the support BA, its direction will be opposite side, and it will become as anti-clockwise or clockwise. according to conditions. If it is clockwise, it will be anti-clockwise. If it's anti-clockwise, it will be in the clockwise address force. And similarly, the same condition will apply on the member B to C. And we will show the directions of the member B to C, and it is according to the Newton's third law, which indicates that if we have a clockwise rotation, then it will become in the opposite direction of the anti-clockwise direction. And same is the case with the shear. If we have a downward shear at the sports, then in the member we will have a upward shear the other members. And same is indicated here in both members. We will have opposite shear than opposite moment. Once we have carried out the successfully drawn the free body diagram, then we can easily write out the equilibrium equations. And equilibrium equations can be written as at the support B, and it indicates that MBA, the moment BA, this moment in the span AB, MBA plus MBC, the moment in the other span MBC, should be equal to zero in order to remain the structure stable. If they are not equal, then ultimately they will cause the bending in the beam, or they will cause the rotation in the beam. So they will be only, the beam will be stable only when the moment values of these moment is in equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Then we will find out the sixth step. We find out the joint rotations, and to determine the joint rotations, we will solve the equations of moments that we have, equation of rotation that we have written in the first step. Or in other words, we will put in the values of the MBA and the values of MBC, which is the equation 5, and solve this equation to get the values of the theta. And the values of MBA, which we calculated in the very second step, MBA, this fourth step in the slope and deflection equation, and its value is 0.16 EI theta B minus 43.2. And the value of MBC that we've calculated is 0.133 EI theta B plus 150. So we will just put in the values of these MBA and MBC in this equation, and equate is equal to zero to get the value of EI theta B. And once we have the value of EI theta B, we can find out the unknown moments or fixed end moments values. So the value of EI theta B we can find out is, its value comes out to be minus 364.5 kip square. And once we have the value of this EI and theta B, we've put it this equation back into the slope and deflection equation to get the values of the moments. That is, the MAB comes out to be 35.6 kip feet, MBA comes out to be minus 101.5 kip feet, MBC comes out to be positive 101.5 kips, and MCB comes out to be minus 174.3 kip feet. And as already mentioned number of times, that the negative sign indicates that the direction that we assume is in the opposite directions. So we will just change the direction of the moment for the values we get the negative sign. Once we calculated the values of the fixed end moment, we just put that values back into the free body diagrams, which we have already drawn in the last steps. That we have the value of MBA, we have the value of MBA, again MBA, MBC, MBC, and MCP. Once we have found out the values of all these unknowns, we just display it on the free body diagram. And then we use these values to find out the member and shears. At the end A, we will have the member and shear comes out to be 8.16 and others comes out to be 9.84. Similarly, for the other span, its value comes out to be 27.57 and 32.43. And in order to calculate these values, you will have just have to take the value of the moment at ether spot A or B equal to 0, or in other words, apply the equation of the moment at summation B y is equal to 0, and we will get the value of A y. And once we find out the value of A y, then you can use the apply the second equation of equilibrium, that is summation F y is equal to 0, to get the value of B y. And similarly, you can apply again the equation of equilibrium, summation Fy is equal to 0, or summation moment is equal to 0, to find out the member and shears for the span B to C. Once we have the shears, we can find out the values of the total spot reactions at the spot, which is the spot B, which is the basically the combination of two shears, which is the shear BA and shear BC. This is sum up. As the direction of both shears is in downward direction, so that's why it will be added, and the shear of BY will be in opposite direction. That is, the value of 9.84 plus 27.57 is downward, so that's why BY will be in the upward directions. And the values of AY will be 8.16, which is the same as the shear, and similarly for member C, its value will be the shear at spot C, and its value will be C 32.43 kips. Once we find out the values of the spot reactions, we just display on the actual beam and show the value of the moments on both spots, fixed end spots, and since there will be no moment at the roller spot or the pin spot, which is, so that's why we do not show the moment of these here, that is positive 101.5 and negative 101.5, because they are going to cancel out each other. That's why the negative moment at the total moment or net moment at the spot B will be equal to 0. So we will have only the reaction at the spot B. Once we have the value of the reactions and the moments, we will apply the equation of equilibrium to check the calculations of member and shears and the spot reactions. And if you get the value of summation Fy is equal to 0 and you get the values of all the forces in the y direction and you get this value equal to 0, it means you are going in the, your calculations are accurate. Similarly, you can also check the values of the moment as well by putting the, or by calculating the moment at any spot and finding out it's coming out to be equal to 0 or not. Once we have the value of the spot reactions, then you can use these spot reactions to find out the value of the shear force diagram. As we have a spot reaction of 8.16 kip upward or in positive, so that's why the shear force diagram will move in the upward direction or the positive direction, 8.16. And from 8 to point load, which of 18 kip, we'll call this at point D. Since there is no load between point A to D, so the shear line will go in the straight direction. And at point D, it will move down the value equal to the applied load, which is 18 kips. And 8.16 minus 18 kips comes out to be 9.84 in the negative direction. So its value will become as minus 9.84, and we will have a negative shear from B to D. And again, at the joint B, we will have the value of the reaction, which is in the positive direction, 37.41. And once we add it, we will reach to the value of 27.57. From point B to C, we will have a UDL distributed load. So in the negative direction, so we will have the first degree of the slope of the shear force diagram from span B to C, D decreasing linearly from point B towards C, and its value 37.41 minus 30, because the span length is 30, 22, 60, minus 627.57 minus 60, and it will comes out to be valued minus 32.43, and its value is when it's added with the reaction at the C, it will ultimately comes back to the value of the zero. And as already I mentioned in the previous lecture as well, that once we have the value of the uniformly distributed load, we have to look at the value of the point of contraflexure. And in order to look at that point of the contraflexure, we have to know the distance from ether spot of the to find out this point of the contraflexure. And you calculate the value of this point of contraflexure by using the principle of similar triangles. And for calculation, that you can compare this triangle ECF, and you can secondly compare this triangle. You can also compare this triangle, which is BHFGH. You can compare these two triangles, ECF and FGH, to find out the value of this span E to C, and that's why it comes out to be 16.25. Similarly, once you have drawn the shear force diagram, you can draw the bending moment diagram by using either the area under the shear force diagrams or by using the method of the sections to find out the values of the bending moment of the beam. And you will get the moment of shape of the bending moment structure like this. Let's move on to the another problem, which is basically the we have a pin supported beam, and we have to find out its reactions and draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams. And in this question or in this particular problem, we have a uniformly distributed load of 15 kilonewton per meter over the entire span of the beam, in both span A to B and B to D, while we have a point load of 16 kilonewton in the span B to D at the center, and the span length of span A to B is 10 meter and B to D is again 10 meter, but we have a point load at a distance of 5 meter in span B to D. The value of EI, we are given with the value of inertia elasticity as 200 gigapascal, and value of inertia is given as 700 into 10 raised to power 6 millimeter 4. So we will move, or we will proceed with the same steps that we have followed in the last problem, that first of all we will find out the number of the degrees of the freedom. As we see that from the deflected shape of the figure, the number of degrees of freedom would be the at pin spot we will have a rotation. So we will have a one rotation at spot A, the second rotation at point B, and the third rotation at point D. So we will have a 3 degrees of the freedom, that is theta A, theta B, and theta T. And but we also know that at the pin spot we will have a moment of value of equal to zero, because there will be no moment or fixed end moment at spot at the pin end, or neither there is the value of the at ether end of the spot. But at the middle of the spot or the middle of the structure, we will have a moment. In both spans, its value is same. That's why we will get the value of the moment in the middle spots as well zero, but there is some value in the middle spots, but the spots which are at the ends, there will be no moments in the spots, whether these are pin spots or these are in the lower spots. So in order to solve these problems, we know that we do not have a moment at the spot A, and we do not have any moment at point B. So we consider these both ends as the hinged ends. Both ends, consider these ends as the hinged end, because we do not have a movement at these. and you apply the modified equations for such type of the beams. And the modified equations for these types of beam is MRH is equal to 3 EI over L into phi theta r minus psi plus fixed end moment RH minus fixed end moment HR by 2. And we apply for solving these types of beam when we do not have a fixed end support beam at the ends. We apply this modified equation, slope deflection equation, to that spans. In this case, we have a pin support in both spans, end of the span, that is A to B and B to D. So we will apply this modified equation on both spans. But if we have a support fixed end at point A and there's a pin support at D, so and while in solving that particular beam in the span A to B, we will apply the simple slope and deflection equations, while in the span B to D we will apply the modified equations. Whenever we have a fixed end and exterior and fixed end support, we will apply the simple slope and deflection equation. But modified slope and deflection equation is applied when we have any other support, or there is a no support, or we have a cantilever structures, then we apply the modified equations that are mentioned here. So once we apply this modified equations, the only degree of freedom that we are left with is the theta b. So indirectly, this simplifies our this question from 3 degrees of freedom to 1 degree of freedom. So it is basically lessen the calculations for our easiness. In the second step, we will calculate the fixed end moments and the fixed end moments for the span A to B, where we have a UDL over the entire length of the beam. This value is WL square by 12. We just plug in the values and find out its value comes out to be 125 kilonewton meter in the anti-clockwise direction. That's why it will be positive. While fixed end moment in other direction, its value comes out to be minus 125 because its value is in the clockwise direction. And you can see the directions are mentioned in the table of fixed end moment as well. Similarly, when we apply the fixed end moment formulas in the span B to D, will get the value as 200 kilonewton meter. As in this span B to D, we have two types of load. One is the UDL and other is the point load. So that's why we will apply the fixed end moment separately and later on add them both moments. So for point load, we will have the formula of PL by A. Here we have P is 16 kilonewton and length of the span is 10 feet divided by 8, which is for the point load. And the second formula is for the UDL load, which is entire length of the beam, which is 15 kilonewton, and its formula is WL square by 12, which is same as the span A to P. And we simply add up these formulas. The result that we get is the ultimate fixed end moment in the span B to D, and its value comes out to be 200 kilonewtons meter in the anti-clockwise direction, the positive direction. And similarly, we have a same fixed end moment in the fixed end moment for D to B, but in opposite directions. Then we find out in the third step, we write out the slope and deflection equations, which is basically we applied the modified deflection equation for both spans. So for MBA, it will become as 3 EI over 10 into theta B. We are only left with the theta B. So as there is no rotation, so its value will be 0, plus fixed end moment at the point B, and its value will be minus 125 divided by 2, because we have a fixed value of MB as minus 125. So that's why we use its value as minus 125, and other is minus 25 by 2, and simplify this equation to get the value of EI theta B. If theta is missing in both equations 1 and 2, just keep it in your minds. Similarly, for MBD, we will apply the formula of 3EI. Here, value of given is EI, but inertia that we have given is 2 times of I. which is mentioned here. For span B to D, we have a value of inertia is given as 2i. For span A to B, its value is given as I. So we will, once we apply this equation, 3EI over I for L span 1 B to D, we'll use the value of I as 2i, and which is mentioned here. 3E into I is value of I is 2i over 10 into theta B plus fixed end moment for BD, that is fixed end for moment BD is 200. This BD value is given as positive 200 kilo Newton meter. And we simplify this equation to get the values of 0.6 EI theta B plus 300. And similarly, the fixed end moment at the other direction, that MDB by the modified deflection equation value will come as 0. And similarly, the moment of MAB will also be 0. If you do not want to apply this equation, you can find out your values by simple moment or simple slope and deflection as well. But for that, you have to consider that we have a 3 degrees of freedom instead of 1. And you have to apply these equations again repeatedly to get your 3 number of unknowns. Once we have these slope and deflection equations, in the first step we write out the equilibrium equation, and we have only one support at the center of the beam, which is roller, so we will have MBA plus MBD equal to 0. In the next step, we find out the joint rotations, and by plugging in the values in this equilibrium equation, that we will plug in the value of MBA and MBD, create it is equal to 0, and to find out the value of EI theta B, and it comes out to be minus 125 kilonewton meter square. Once we have the value of EI theta B, we find out the member and moments. By plugging the value of EI theta B into the moment equations, if we find at the end, once we put in the value of minus 125 as EI theta B, we find out that values of MBA comes out to be minus 225 kilonewton meter, and MBD comes out to be positive 225 kilonewton meter. Once we have the values of these moments, we calculate the member and shields and the support reaction. And you will get the values of the sports reaction as shown in the slides. And once we have these member and shears, you just add up the values of the shears and the sports to find out the sports reactions. And once you get the values of these sports reactions, you can draw the SFDs and VMDs to find out these shear force diagrams and bending moment diagrams. But before that, you can apply the equilibrium check on your beam as well after find out your sports reaction, or you can skip this part as well. It's up to you. And later on, once we find out these all moments, you can easily draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams using the procedures I already told you in structure analysis. Let's move to the third and the last problem of today's lecture, where we have a support settlement in the beam, and we have to find out the member end moments and the reactions for the three span continuous beam. And the length of each span is 20 feet, and we have a uniformly distributed load of 2 kip per foot over the entire length of the beam. The value of elasticity is given as 29,000 KSI, and the value of inertia is given as 7,800 H4, and it is same for the entire span of the beams. And the support settlement is given as that the point B settles about 5 by 8 inches, point C settles about 1.5 inches, and point D settles about 3 by 4 inches. So we will have a support settlement at point B, point C, and point D. So all supports are settling except support 1. You can have a multiple support settlement in your structures as well, or you can have only one court settlement in the entire structures. So it all depends on the conditions. And to solve these type of questions, you will move the same steps that we all applied or we are choosing in the solving the slope and deflection equations. So first of all, we will find out the number of unknown joint rotations, and if we apply the modified equations on these spans, we know that at fixed span we will have a zero moment, and with point D again we will have a zero moment because it is a pin support. So the only unknown joint rotations are we are left with at point B and at point C. So we will have two number of joint rotations, that is theta B and theta C. So we will have a 2 degrees of the freedom for this particular beam. In the second step, we calculate the fixed end moments, and the values of the fixed end moments will be WL square by 12. As we have a same UDL load over the entire span of the length, so we can say that fixed end moment A to B, fixed end moment B to C, and fixed end moment C to D all will be equal, and its value will be 66.7 kip fit positive. And for the fixed end moment BA and CB and DC, its value will be again 66.7 but in negative direction. Okay, the important point that I want to teach this particular problem to you is the deflection of the support settlement or deflection of the beam. And it is scattered in the step 3, which is the cohort rotation. For all the problems that we have solved so far, its value is considered as zero because there is the no support settlement. But for this particular type of the beam, we are given that we will have a beam settlement at point B is 5 by 8 inches, at point C it is 1.5 inches, and at point D it is 3 by 4 inches. 3 by 4 is approximately equal to 0.75 inches, and at point C it is 1.5 inches, and at point D, 5 by 8 inches is approximately equal to 0.625 inches. And in order to calculate that, we will have to find out the value of the psi as well for all three spans, because we have a support settlement in all three spans. If we have only one support settlement, suppose we have only support settlement at point B, then we will only find out the value of the psi AB, while the value of psi BC and psi CD will be zero if they have a no support settlement. But in this case, they have a support settlement, so we will find out the value of the psi AB, psi BC, and psi CD. And I already mentioned you in the first lecture of the slope and deflections, while explaining you the basic terminologies involved in the slope and deflection method, is that psi AB is equal to deflection over length. The formula for psi AB is deflection in the particular frame divided by length. The important point that you need to remember here is that psi is a unitless quantity, and the units of both deflection and the length should be the same. For example, in the span A to B, we have a given of deflection of 5 by 8 inches. So, and the length is given as 20 feet. So, either you have to convert the length into inches or you have to convert the deflection into feet. So, what I have done for the part A to B, that I have converted this deflection 5 by 8 inches into feet. That is 5 by 8 comes out to be 0.625, and when you divide this value of 5 by 8 inches divided by 12, you will get the value of 0.0521 in feet. And once you have the value of this, 20 feet and deflection in the feet, you can divide it and you will get the values of psi AB as -0.0026. Similarly, for psi BC, you will find out its value as 0.0725. but its value will be little bit tricky. It's not simply you will get its value. The for the psi b, we have to measure the Hart reflections. For the span a to b, the net reflection occurring in the span b to c. So the net deflection occurring in the span b to c is this part. That is, deflect point c is deflecting about 1.5 inches and point b is deflecting about 5 by 8 inches. So what you will do is you will minus these values to get this value of the deflections. And once you have the value of this value of deflection, suppose I called it as x, you divided it with its length to find out this angle, or I would say this psi b c, the net deflection. So 0.025 is calculated as 1.5, which is the deflection at point C, minus deflection at point D, which is point B, which is 5 by 8 inches. And 5 by 8 inches comes out to be 0.625. As it's this value is in inches, I have to divide this value by 12 to convert it into inches. And once you convert this value into inches, you will get the value of 0.0729, but in negative sign, with negative sign. So then you divide this value of 0.0279 with the span length, which is 20 feet, to get the value of psi bc as -0.00365. Similarly, for phi cd, you will have to measure this value of the x again, this span, this difference, and its difference will be 1.5 minus 3 by 4 inches, which is 0.75, divided by the, you have to convert it either into length or into feet. And for the first two parts, I am converting the units into feet. And the second part or the third part, just to make you understand, I have converted this value into inches. So what I have done is that for deflection, it is 1.5 minus 3 by 4. So it will be in inches. And the length of 20 feet is divided, multiplied by 12 to get the value of the span length is also in inches. Once these values are both in inches, you will get the value of 0.00313. Once you have find out the values of this psi, then you have to apply the slope and deflection equations. And we have, by modified deflection equations, we will have the value of MAB equal to 0. And for MBA, it will be 3EI over L into theta B plus deflection. This is value of the deflection, which is this value, point psi AB. Value is -0.0026. And 1 is the minus of the equations. Minus will be multiplied with the minus, and this sign will become as positive, because the modified deflection equation is itself has a minus sign. This is deflection, rotation minus deflection. So minus sign, you have minus quad rotations. So this minus sign of the formula will be multiplied with the negative sign of this rotation, that is -0.0026. And it will ultimately get into the positive sign, minus fixed end moment, which is the -100 that we have calculated in the last step. Sorry, there is a mistake in this question. This value is not 100, but its value is 66.7. Just correct it in your notes. Make sure that you have used the correct value in your further calculations. Oh no, this value is correct, because you have do not have to use the only the single value of the moment, but you will going to use the fixed end moment minus half of the fixed end moment, and its value will become as 100, because you will have the value of 66.7 and the half of 66.7 is 33. 66 plus 33 comes out to be 100. So this value is correct. You have, as per modified equations, the value of the fixed end moment is fixed end moment minus fixed and half of the fixed end moment. So one, that's why it is 66.7 plus half of this 66.7 comes out to be 100. So this equation is correct. And then we have to apply this equation MBC, and the span MBC, B to C, this span, and the span B to C. And the span B to C, we will apply the simple slope and deflection equations, because we do not have, it's not the last end or exterior end of the beam. Whenever we have an interior end of the beam, we will apply the simple moment equation. And its value is 2 EI over L into 2 times theta of B plus theta C minus 3 times, which is the formula, which is the part of the formula 1, is 3 times psi. And the value of psi BC is calculated as minus 0.00365. So we will have the value of psi as minus 0.00365 plus fixed end moment, and its value is 66.7. Then you will simplify this equation. Similarly, you will simplify the equation for MCB and for again MCD. It's for MCD, it's again the exterior span. You will also apply the modified deflection equation in the exterior span. That is 3 EI over L. And again, the value of fixed end moment here will become as 100. And for the last, that is MBC, it will value become as 0. So the important point that you need to remember from here is that whenever you have a pin support at the exterior support, we will apply the modified slope deflection equations. But for all the interior spans, we will apply the simple or the basic slope and deflection equations like we applied here in the span B. For span A and C or D, the modified deflection equation is applied here. And remember how we use the value, calculated the value of psi, and how we plug it into this equation. And once, then the last next step is you have to write the equilibrium equations, as we have two number of unknowns, one is at B, one is at C. So we will have MBA plus MB equal to 0 as equation 5, and MCB plus MCD is equal to 0 as equation 6. Once you have these equations, you have just have to input the values of these four moments. That is MBA, that is calculated as 0.35 EI theta B plus EI theta C, and it will become as equal to 0.00449 EI plus 33.34 MBC. And similarly for to span, we will apply the next two equations and simplify it and cancel it. You will get the values of these values. But during rearranging, make sure that you will have the values of theta B and theta C on the one side, and the number of the constant and the value of EI on the other side. You will get the value of 33.3 from these moments. That once you subtract the value of 100 from 66.7, you will get the value of 33.3. Now, in this equation, we are given the value of E as 29,000 KSI, and the inertia is given as 7,800 inch four. And you will convert this 7,800 inch four into feet. That is kip feet square. Remember that whenever we have the equation of in terms of EI, its unit is always in kip feet squares. The length is always in inches square. So you will have to only divide with the 12 square instead of 12 raised to power 4. Once you input the values of EI, you will further move closer to your solution. And your equation will be further simplified as 0.35 EI theta B plus 0.1 EI theta C equal to minus 2307.24 as equation 7, and similarly you will find out the equation 8. Then you will solve these two equations simultaneously, either with the help of the calculator or by using the factorization or elimination method, to find out the values of EI theta B and EI theta C. You will find out the value of EI theta B as minus 6268.81 kip feet square, and EI theta C as 1131.5781 kip feet square. Once we have the value of EI theta B and theta C, we plug these values back into moment member and moment equation, and we will find out the net values of the moment for all unknown moments, that is MBA, MBC, MCB, and MCD. Once you have the values of these moments, then you show this value or draw the simply supported structures or a free body diagram of the beam to find out the member and shears. And member and shears will be calculated as I already mentioned in the last examples. Once you have calculated the member and shears, then you will calculate the value of the support reactions. Remember that there will be no moment in this type of the beam, because at point A we have used the assumption that is the pin support, so there is no moment, and so end up point D. While at point B and at point C, the value of the moment is same in the both span, that is value of one on one side of the support it is positive 1808, on the other side it is negative 808, so it will ultimately going to cancel out its effect on the support B, and its value of the moment will be zero at point B. And same is the case with the point C. Once you calculate the value of the reactions, then you can easily draw the shear force diagrams. And for shear force diagram, at point A we have a negative of value of minus 138, then we have a UDL, so it will be in the first degree downward line. Then support reaction is added at point D, again negative line, due to negative line the slope will be decreased, and at the point C the reaction is again in downward direction, so it will further move downward. Again, the UDL will decrease this value further to minus 64, and the reaction at point E will bring it close to zero. And then you will draw the last step, you will draw the bending moment diagram of this particular beam. And you will get the value of moment at point A as zero and point B as zero. While you get the value of moment at point B as minus 427.6 and point C as 808.2. That's all for today. In order to study further, you should solve in your own time all the examples of the topic of slope and deflection related to beams. And the relative solution of the beam, that is the example 11.1 to 11.4 of the structural analysis book of R.C. Hippler, 8th edition, that we are following in this course. I have also uploaded these books on the LMS. You can also download from these books and practice these examples in your own time. Further, I will suggest you to also solve the examples or the problems of this chapter, that is 11.1 to 11.17, which are related to the beams. So should also solve these problems of these books in your own time. And if you encounter any difficulty in any question or any example, do ask me. You can post your questions or any difficulties in the comment section of this video, or you can ask me directly by emailing me to my email address, or you can also ask me the WhatsApp group chat. That's all for today. If you have any questions, I will be more than happy to answer it. Okay, that's all from my side. Take care of yourself.